Today we're going to be talking about the jumping spider, in particular a species called the Phidippus Audax, which is a jumping spider that has green and sometimes blue iridescent mouthpieces that really make it outstanding to see, especially when the sun hits those mouthpieces. The jumping spider to me is the most exciting spider that one can study, think about, observe, hunt, catch. It's a great spider. It's not like the other spiders that need to build a web to catch their prey, who have poor eyesight and detect the insects in their web by the feeling of vibrations. The jumping spider actually stalks its prey, much like a lion would going after a prey in the wilderness, carefully stalking and planning at the right moment, pouncing upon its victim. And this is how the jumping spider reacts and works. Great eyesight. They have eyesight that's even comparable to the human's eyesight. They have like binocular vision in the first four eyes. The two big ones in the center of the binocular vision gives them great eyesight, very close to human eyesight. Matter of fact, in some ways it goes beyond what the humans see, because there's something called the tetrachromatic color that takes the jumping spider into the actual infrared area of ultraviolet lights that we can't even see. So they have excellent eyesight, they're very curious, and they're not intimidated very well. So it's fun to watch these spiders. The other thing is, they're called jumping spiders because they love to jump. And we'll be looking at that a little bit later on in the video clip. They can jump up to 20, 40, even 60 times their own body length. And they have such a variety of colors and shapes and sizes that I think you'll find this to be interesting. It's my favorite spider. I really love them. And you know, not only do they go after insects and that for prey to eat, but they also enjoy finding nectar in flowers. So I want you to just take a look at a face, couple faces here, and tell me if this is not a face that only a mother could love. They're not very easy to find and to hunt. Usually you bump into them accidentally or they bump into you accidentally. But they're certainly a great spider to have interest and enjoyment in, which I do thoroughly. I'm going to be taking a look at a couple jumping spiders that I've caught previously in a container. So let's take you there and we'll show you some more about the jumping spider.
What you're looking at is jumping spiders. There's actually two of them in the container here. And they happen to be both males. Male jumping spiders will confronted when confronted with each other, they'll raise their front legs up in the air to hopefully threaten off the other spider. We'll see how that all works here in just a minute.
Notice when they confront each other, they lift and spread the front two legs. And this is one of the only or a few spiders that can walk backwards. Notice him walking backwards, his arms raised. And now he really raises them, hoping to fend off his other male counterpart. Decides he's bigger than he is, so he better leave. This jumping spider is very unique in that its feet, on the pads of its feet, it has very, very tiny hairs that allow it to even crawl across glass. Here you can see, looking down from the top, the iridescent mouthpieces, and right below those, you'll notice the two fangs that intersect there with each other. They spread those apart from side to side, and then they can grab their victim and inject their venomous poison to subdue the prey. This also gives us a chance to look at the four eyes on the front of the spider. You notice the two main ones in the center that are glowing. That's the ones that have the binocular kind of vision, that very keen eyesight. They're very curious. They love to look at things, check things out, and you can see these two males that I have on my hand now. They're going to interact with each other in just a few moments. Notice as I approach with the camera, one kind of stands its ground near the bottom, and the one near the top gets a little bit shy, kind of backs off a little bit. Watch the one in the back raise its arms, challenging the other male spider. And of course, jumping spiders go by their great name because they love to jump. Some 4,300 species of jumping spiders make this, for me, one of the most interesting and fascinating of all the spiders. Hey, could you give us that profile one more time? Thank you.